In this tutorial, we are going to learn about forms in Access 2010, creating a simple form or a compound form for entering, displaying, and updating data into an Access database. If you're interested in learning about designing the tables, designing queries, and linking the tables together, please check the previous two tutorials. So, in this case, we have three tables. We have the contracts table, we have the customers table, and then we have the invoices table. We additionally have some queries that we played with earlier. Now at this time, let's say we wanted to create a form. The forms can be created for a specific table or parts of that table, or they can be created with the data from more than one table. So let's say we wanted a form based on the customers table. So we click under customers table, then we click on create, then we go under form wizard. Notice there are different types of all kinds of different options here. So we'll go under form wizard, that will be the easiest. And let's say we want all the fields in here in this table. Notice we can put this, click right here, click on next, next. You could modify the design, but basically we're just going to leave it alone for now. Press finish, and that's the form. So notice, to open it back up, notice now it's giving us only the data from each specific customer. Notice you can move to the next customer, next, next, next. And to create a new record, let's say you had created a new record here, the customer ID is going to be assigned automatically. Let's say and you basically enter the data that way. Once you press next here, that record has been updated automatically. So if we wanted to go back, that's the record that we just created. Now if we wanted to, let's say, look up a customer, we want to look up, let's say, Claire from the form. You could search for that customer right here, and notice it brings up right away. If we want to search for Hubert, automatically. So that's how the form basically works. Note that you can change the forms by clicking on Home here, and then you go under View. And under Views, there's a Layout view where you can add new fields, change different properties, specify different themes. Notice if we want to change how it looks. So that was under View, and then the Design view, actually the View and the Layout view. And then if we wanted to modify additional things, how, where things show up, how they look, and all that type of thing, then we go on the Design view and modify it from there. So notice these, you can click on these areas here or on these fields and resize it accordingly. Move things around, make things bold, or however you want to format them accordingly to your liking there. You can add a logo, you can add additional things as well, like you could add a logo here. By simply selecting a picture, and then it'll show up right there. So once you're ready and done, you go back to form view, and notice we changed the customer ID to bold, we resized the street address so it was not as wide, and it's there. So that's a simple form. Save it once you design it. Now the next item that I'll show you here is how to create a compound form. So let's say, remember we had a customer can have more than one order. So let's say you want to have a list of each customer on the form. And then under each customer you want to list all their orders or all their contacts. So the way you do that is by using the form wizard again, or you could use it form design, but form wizard it's the simplest in this case. And we pick all the fields from customer ID or the customers table. Then we go under the contacts table and we want the contact number. We don't need the customer ID in this case because we have it from a previous table. Then we choose the amount, the date, and the type. Then we click on next. Now the grouping is, this is how we are going to group it. So we're basically going to see the customer information on the top, and then right below it we're going to have all the different contracts for each customer. So you could define it how you want it. So this would be the best. You want to order it by customers. Then we click on next. Click on next again. You could give it a name. Finish. And it's going to look something like this. So notice we have Alex here. He has this order, next one. And if we wanted to add a new order for this customer here, you just type it directly under this entry. So this is basically, it's through the forms that we can display the data much easier, and that we can update the data in the tables. Again, we enter the data here, it gets stored in the tables. And then we move to the next customer and so on. So let's say all of a sudden at one point we got a call from Amber. We just type Amber here and it brings up our data. Notice for more, these would be all the different orders or contacts that they have with us. Again, this order, you can close it and then open it up again, and then go under home here, under view, the layout view, and you can specify different themes the way you like it, or change it however it looks nicest for you. You can change the different colors. Change the fonts. And add new fields and different properties as well. You want to change the design, change it from here. And then when you're all done, you go under the form view. And notice it moved the email. So that's how the forms work. Basically, keep in mind, it's showing up this way because we have linked the tables together. Keep in mind as well that whenever you update the data in the forms, it gets stored into the tables. If you delete your data from your tables, nothing is going to show up in your queries or in your forms or in your reports. So that's very important.